Okay, I call the April 9th, 2018 regular council meeting to order and ask for a roll call, please.
Bobby Mock?
Yes.
Catherine Whitman?
Here.
Chris Baca?
Here.
Kevin Plaine?
Here.
Robin Dunlap?
Here.
Debbie Nasta?
Here.
Joe Baker?
Here, we have a quorum established and ask everyone in the audience to please join us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everyone. Moving along to comments, not scheduled for public comments, excuse me, items not on this evening's agenda. If you have comments for this evening, if anything not on the agenda, please come forward. If not, we're moving forward. We'll go down to the consent agenda right quick. And this evening, we're looking at the March 26, 2018 regular meeting minutes. Accounts payable for dated April the 9th today, 2018, in the amount of $403,367.88. Approval of resolution 1831 for June 18th, almost free building permit program. It's a good program. 1832, approving a contract and notice of award to Northern Colorado Constructions, Constructors, Inc., for Glen Eyre Street project for $595,246 and the total project amount not to exceed $632,771. 1833, approving expenditure of $21,443 for amenities for Dave Osborne Park. 1834, approving contract with Loris Trucking LLC for installation of sidewalk chases at Sharp Farms in the amount of $10,290. 1835, approving a contract notice to award Northern Colorado Constructors, Inc. for Sundance Water Meter Installation Project for $311,950, and the total amount not to exceed $345,345. Resolution 1836, approving a temporary employment agreement with Sheila Roosh. Say it right? For gardening services, and 1838, approving First Amendment on City Manager Employment Agreement. Council, this is usually voted by a motion, and everyone is running through this pretty standard agenda items. If any council member sees any items to be pulled off the agenda and put down to the regular general business, please do so, and then make a motion with those items being removed for us, and then we'll ask for a vote. I think I said all that right. I'm still foggy from the weekend. My brain kind of hurts today. Sorry, folks.
Mine too. I wanted to move item F down for.
So you'll make a motion approving all items as presented, with the exception of the item that you're speaking about, and ask that that be moved down to general business, and that would be your motion, and then you would get a second, and we'll vote on that.
All right, so I'll make a motion to accept or move item F down to general business, and...
Okay. So you'll make a motion to accept the consent agenda as presented,
removing item F down to general business.
There you go. Motion by Chris, second by Kathy. Can we receive a vote? Oh, do you want me to say the motion back again or just move forward? Never mind. So motion by Chris, second by Kathy. Can we receive a vote, please?
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
That motion passes with all saying yes, with F, item number F being moved down to general business. Thanks for your patience, everyone. Sorry about that. Next is opening a public hearing for resolution 1837, approving final development plan for Autumn Valley Ranch, filing number 3. And I believe our applicant is coming up to present for us.
Good evening, Mayor, council members. My name is Cindy Myers. I'm with Century Communities, and I'm excited to be here tonight and show you.
I got to get you sworn in really quick.
Sorry.
That's okay.
I'm just gonna get right there.
Do you swear affirm that the testimony you're about to give before the Dacono City Council will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you.
So I'm gonna move this over a little bit, if that's okay?
Sure.
Maybe. All right, so we are talking tonight about Autumn Valley Ranch filing number 3. As, can everybody see that okay? Sort of orientation, this was filing one down here that was partially constructed when we purchased the property, and we have continued to build out homes through here. This run right here is filing 2, which is currently under construction. We're getting ready to pave top lift out here. So that's what's currently under construction. What we're talking about tonight is filing 3, which is simply this little section right here. And then in the future, very near future, we'll be presenting filing 4, that is this area over here. With this, we have the detention pond to the north. This is sort of an open area. Both of these areas will remain as open areas. And then with filing 3, what we're bringing in is the centralized park area. So that park is currently designed and planned to have these large open play fields, pedestrian connections walking all the way through and up to other connections for this filing and the sidewalks and the rest of the filing. And then here in the center, we've got benches and picnic tables and trail systems that go through landscaping in all these areas. Fairly simple.
And that's north, right? The way you have that.
I apologize.
That's okay. So no. If we're going
this
that way is north. Okay.
Correct.
Thank you. That's all right.
Also with this FDP that is before you, we are also bringing in additional architecture, additional house plans. We've got 9 plans all together that are going to have 3 elevations each. So that's going to give a greater variety to the street scene out there. This is 6 of the plans. 1 elevation is shown here, but there are 3 per home. And then the remaining 3. So I don't have much more for you. I'm happy to answer any questions.
I have a couple questions. Just out of curiosity, what's your price range on the new on the newer models?
They'll be in the same as the other ones.
In the 400s?
There's a couple that may be a little less, but.
And the park, any plan for shade?
We didn't put any shade structures in there at the moment. So.
Just a suggestion, because we found in the park that the city has developed that we needed to go back and add shade. So just a suggestion. Your residents might like it. And then finally, do you advertise this? Do you have a sales office that the residents that currently live there can find out what you're doing?
Yes, we do have a sales office. We are currently looking at building a second model out there. We currently have one. And at any point in time, they're welcome to call in.
They can go in.
Uh-huh. I'm also happy Jennifer has my contact. If anybody calls the city, they're certainly welcome to call me and ask me any kind of questions they have. So, if Jennifer would like to give that out or put that out there for people, I'm happy to answer questions.
Thank you.
Sure.
Just a comment and just kind of a weird curiosity question, really. I think the park is fabulous. I think it's a generous and beautiful park. Very impressed with it, actually. And then the curious question is the 2 homes down on the southern end of it, they just seem kind of oddly placed. Any comment on that, or
those are probably going to be 2 of the most valuable homes.
Right, that's what I was thinking.
where are they in the map?
Bring the park back.
So it would be those 2.
Yeah.
Those are.
Yeah, those will be a little more than 400. It's a skosh.
But otherwise, I mean, at least the aerial view and just kind of my imagination on it, it's a beautiful park, so.
We're hoping that it should be, and I'll certainly take the park shelter type thing back and see what we can do.
So is there playground amenities for the families in the park there?
Just benches.
It's really benches and picnic tables and those kind of things.
Not to get off. I mean, those little round things right there are going to be trees, right?
Yes.
Okay, so they'll get there.
Yeah.
Bushes or trees? You said she didn't have trees.
Well, no, those are trees. Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
No other questions?
For the applicant?
Thank you.
Beautiful. Thank you so much for your presentation. I think we're having the administration speak now. Come on down.
Thank you, Mayor and Council. This is a public hearing for your consideration of Council Resolution 1837, recommending approval of a final development plan for Autumn Valley Ranch Filing 3. Items that should be entered into the public hearing record this evening include the staff report dated April 9th, 2018, the Dacono Municipal Code, the application and all supporting documents, the final plat dated March 12th, 2018, and the PUD final development plan dated March 12th, 2018. By way of background, the overall final plat for Autumn Valley Ranch, this entire project, was approved by Resolution 0422. And at the time, the subdivision plat included 247 lots divided into four filings for single family development. As the applicant stated, filing one has been constructed, two is underway. This is the FDP for filing three. So this evening, you're not actually approving the subdivision itself because it has been approved and individual filings are administratively approved. But what is under consideration this evening is the FDP, or the final development plan. You may recall that by ordinance 822, this subdivision was originally zoned MH, manufactured housing. When Century Community purchased the subdivision, they rezoned it to R1 and did a PUD overlay to provide some additional flexibility in maximum building height, minimum lot size, and rear yard setbacks. And so with each filing, you approve a final development plan, and that is what's under your consideration. So just like in the preliminary plan, the maximum building height will be 35 feet. The minimum lot size will be 5,000 square feet. And the rear setbacks for primary structures are 25 and 15 feet for covered patios or decks. Additional items that we did take under consideration with this was the outlot A, the open space, which the applicant did explain includes a variety of play fields as well as trails and benches for passive recreation. The elevations were also reviewed, and as the applicant indicated, they are including additional elevations again to provide variation in the development, which we think will continue to add to the overall quality appearance of this particular neighborhood. And staff is recommending approval of the FDP for filing three without any conditions. Are there any questions?
Questions for the administration, council?
No.
How many homes were there?
Originally 247 were approved, and that number has not, I think it might have been reduced by possibly one lot. This particular filing includes 43 lots.
I'd just like to say that being on council for a while, and the same thing with you, Kevin, it's interesting, 14 years later, right, ordinance 04, thanks to the developer for stepping up and taking on that challenge and building homes, and thanks to the administration for streamlining the process from where you guys were way back in the day. I know before your time, but I'm sure it's been a lot easier watching that whole thing grow, and it's nice to see an end game coming up with the development is beautiful. The homes look great. The parks are going to be cool, and everybody's going to benefit from those homes all through the area. So that's my rant. Thanks. Thank you, administration. Thanks, Jim. All right, council. We'll close the public hearing. Is there any public comments to be made about this issue? Seeing none, we will close the public hearing and move it back to council for action or discussion.
I make a motion for the approval of resolution 1837, approving the final development plan for Autumn Valley Ranch, filing number 3.
Second.
Motion by Kathy, second by Kevin. Can we receive a vote, please?
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Bobby?
Yes.
And that motion passes with all saying yes. Next is section B, which is ordinance 843, and we're going to look for a motion to postpone the hearing indefinitely.
Yes.
Is what we're looking for, council.
Make a motion to postpone the public hearing and approval ordinance 843, amending chapter 16, article 30, non-residential design standards on second reading.
Second.
Indefinitely.
To a date indefinitely.
Indefinitely.
Second.
All right, motion by Kathy, second by Kevin. Can we receive a vote, please?
Chris?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Oh, yes.
That motion passes with all saying yes. Next, excuse me, is the opening of the public hearing for ordinance 844, amending chapter 16, article 24, regarding site plans on second reading. And I believe it's Jen, come on up.
This is the public hearing and second reading for your consideration of ordinance 844, an ordinance amending chapter 16, article 24 of the Dacono Municipal Code regarding site plans. Items entered into the public hearing record this evening include the Dacono Municipal Code and the staff report dated April 9th, 2018. At the first reading, I did walk the council through this ordinance. And what it does is it requires site plans for any change of use unless otherwise waived by the community development director. The notion behind it is that frequently we do have a change in use for a particular site that warrants the need for a new site plan. For example, an addition of a drive-through facility and or a change in use from a commercial or from a residential dwelling to a commercial use because it's zoned commercial residential, therefore not necessitating a zoning change. And the only opportunity we have right now with the way our development or with our zoning code is to make sure the parking is adequate. But there are a host of other issues that often are associated with a change in use, such as parking and circulation, location of dumpsters, any alterations to the exterior of the building or signage that probably do warrant review by the Planning Commission and City Council. And this ordinance would again provide for a site plan review unless otherwise waived when there is a change in use. Staff is recommending approval of ordinance 844.
Questions for the administration?
I have none.
Being a public hearing, any public comments made on this article or issue? Seeing none, we'll close the public hearing and put it back in council's hands for action or discussion.
I'd like to make a motion for a public hearing and approval of ordinance 844, amending chapter 16, article 24, regarding site plans on second reading.
Second.
Motion by Robin, second by Chris. Can we receive a vote, please?
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
That motion passes with all saying yes. Next is opening a public hearing for ordinance 845 regarding beekeeping in the city of Dacono on second reading, and I think we defer to AJ?
Yes.
All right, AJ, you're up, sir. Apparently, it was like an electronic way.
I had it. Did you get it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you, Mayor.
Sir.
So last year, the city received complaints that beekeeping activities were being conducted within the city in a manner that was impacting the peace and enjoyment of properties located within the vicinity of such hives. With Ordinance 838 adopted on September 11th, 2017, council imposed a temporary moratorium on the keeping of bees within the city, except that any person then keeping bees could apply for and receive a license for hives to authorize the keeping of bees during the pendency of the moratorium, subject to the regulations adopted in the ordinance. That temporary moratorium ended March 31st of this year. No applications were received to license existing hives during the period of the moratorium, and the beekeeping activities known to the city at the time of the moratorium was imposed were voluntarily ceased. Council therefore desires by this ordinance to prohibit beekeeping activities within the city and repeal the regulations and licensing that were in effect during the term of the moratorium. This beekeeping prohibition is contained in Chapter 7, which lists prohibited animals, but may be permitted by a planned unit development, final development plan for property located within a PUD zone district, approved pursuant to Chapter 16, Article 28 of the Dacono Municipal Code. And that's where it just kind of defers to another area. So it's a little... Second reading, and no changes have been made to this ordinance since the first reading. And I will be happy to answer any questions.
Questions for the administration, council? Pretty cut and dry on this one. We've been talking about this since September. Yeah. This one should be easy, so.
Motion to approve ordinance 845.
I got to do any public comments to be made on this issue? That's okay. They're all pouring in today. seeing none, we'll close the public hearing and put it back in council's hands. For a motion, Bobby, you're up.
Motion to approve ordinance 845 regarding beekeeping in the city on second reading.
Second.
Motion by Bobby, second by Robin. Can we receive a vote, please?
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
That motion passes with all saying yes. Next is approval of ordinance 846, amending the Dacono Municipal Code to add penalties for late payment of the city's lodging excise tax on first reading. And we will, that's just an ordinance, no public hearing. Beautiful. And that is AJ again?
Yes.
Oh, let's do this.
Yeah, this is a housekeeping ordinance, but since it's in our code, it has to be, and as a tax question, it has to be done by ordinance. When ordinance 839 was adopted in November 2017, there was no specific penalty for late payment of lodging taxes included. There's a reference to when a payment becomes past due, and there is a specific interest charge per month overdue, and that's 1% a month listed, but there is no specific late payment penalty. The intent was for the penalty provision to be included, but it was not in the ordinance. Amending the code to allow for the 10% late payment penalty or 100% penalty for late payment due to fraud will make the lodging tax code's penalties the same as those for the late payment of sales tax. So it's just treating all the taxes the same with late penalties. And that's all I have.
Beautiful. Questions for the administration council?
Yeah, Andrew, so I understand it brings it in line with our sales tax penalties, but I mean, I don't know. I mean, what's the difference between a penalty and a fine? Because I worry about, and I'm glad the city lawyer is here, because I'm concerned about limitations in our charter.
Sure, the limitations in the charter are with regard to fines imposed by the Dacono Municipal Court, and these will be administrative penalties that aren't the result of a summons and court appearance and judgment from the court. So that would be the difference between a fine and a penalty.
Okay, so in your opinion, we're
this is compliant with the charter.
Compliant with the charter, okay.
Yes, absolutely.
And then is there a means by which people can appeal any kind of administrative penalties?
I don't recall if we have
Sorry, I'm asking a tough question.
That's okay. You know, I can pull it up and take a look at it while you all deliberate.
Sure. Sorry, I just want to make sure that this is totally...
So while she's pulling that up, elaborate.
Yeah, what cases would that be?
I mean, in other words, a municipal code, the way I'm reading this, is a fine imposed by a code violation, weeds too high, whatever.
Yeah.
And then this one's basically taxes not being paid.
Yeah, and I'm
so
fine.
Because we're self-collecting now, so we're pretty much catching... I mean, as we've passed this self-collecting, and as the municipal code's being looked through, we're finding these little bits and pieces of facets, house cleaning items, which we've been doing for the past, what, 8-9 years now.
Yeah, no, I mean, I'm fine. If the city attorney, in her opinion, you know, that we're good with the charter, then I don't have any problem with it. But I think, you know, I'm thinking in terms of due process and making sure that we have a means to allow people to appeal any kind of penalties.
Yeah, because your second question did kind of raise what sort of cases, you know, would apply.
Yeah.
Well, I know in the past, anytime we've got something like this, you know, there's where something is done by the administration, we have to provide a means of appeal. Usually is what I've, just in my experience. And I just want to make sure that before we vote one way or another, that we've got ourselves covered.
Interesting.
Okay, well, okay. Unfortunately,
I put you on the spot.
This ordinance has not been codified yet, so I'm not.
Well, I'm sure it would result back into state hands, because I don't think anyone's ever...
There's we no, locally collect.
Yeah, now that we locally collect is why we're doing this, to be able to impose these penalties when no one pays on time. I do know that.
Hey, what do we do with water bills? I mean, it's a similar
Well, if it's
kind of
a
situation.
Municipal code, just like the water bill, we have the right to go turn water off, right?
Right, I mean, but
that's,
I mean, but people can
appeal. Can they appeal that if we go turn somebody's water off?
No, you just pay your bill. And then
right,
they turn
but they
your
can't
water.
Appeal.
The appeal is
There's not an
bill.
Appeal process.
Correct.
Just pay your bill.
Right.
Same thing with the municipal code for
right, tax.
For
Most
that,
of the time,
for
if
tax
you're, yeah, if you're,
it's the same thing. There's no appeal. Just pay your taxes.
Yeah, if you're to the point where you're
right.
imposing a penalty, you're obviously in, you know,
right.
you're in the principal's office for a reason.
Right.
So.
That's what I'm saying. To me, that'd be the same thing, right?
Yeah. Well, we certainly understand the concern. My suggestion would be this is first reading of the ordinance, and so if you adopt it on first reading, we still have our second reading public hearing, and we will follow up on the, you know, administrative appeals process. If it isn't already in the ordinance, we'll make sure that we add something to it. To
Fair enough.
That.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
All right. Here's your answer. All right, council. No other questions for the administration.
That one's Kevin's. Go ahead.
We'll talk to him later. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, if he's driving a Ford pickup too, PD, just to let you know. Back in your hands.
All right, I'll make a motion.
That's what I meant.
Let's see, approve ordinance 846 amending the Dacono Municipal Code to add penalties for late payment of the city's lodging tax, excise tax on first reading.
Second. Oh, motion by Kevin, second by Chris. Can we move to a vote, please?
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
All right, that motion passed with all saying yes on first reading. Next is ordinance 847 extending the terms of a franchise for the supply and distribution of natural gas granted to Black Hills Gas Distribution LLC, doing business as Black Hills Energy, FKA Source Gas Distribution LLC, on first reading. And this is AJ?
Yes, sir.
Let's go.
Thank you. The city entered into a franchise agreement with Source Gas in March of 2008. That agreement expired in February of 2018. Since approving the agreement, Source Gas was acquired by Black Hills Energy. The city is in the process of negotiating with Black Hills Energy for a new franchise agreement. This extension will provide the time needed to adopt a new agreement. I had been in contact with our contact with Black Hills, and initially she's like, oh, you know, we'll be fine, it expired. You know, we'll still collect the franchise fee for you. It didn't mean anything like that. I felt it would be better to actually have a formal extension like we've done in the past with some other agreements. So Kathleen's office prepared this. They, Black Hills sent one over, but ours was better, so we used that one. So this gives us time to negotiate a new agreement, which we have and we're currently working on. So they initially wanted a 25-year term, and our charter only allows a 10-year term. So.
And what's holding us up?
No, not really. It's just working it through the system.
Yeah. Cool. Questions for the administration, council?
The extension is to June 29th. Is that the extension date? Like what you put in here?
Well, okay. It's or.
Or sooner.
Or sooner.
Okay.
2028.
No, 18.
28. Oh, I'm sorry.
No, for the negotiation.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. My bad.
To extend the current.
Thanks, Dave.
Yeah.
Right.
All right. Cool. Any other questions? All right. Back in your hands, council, for action or discussion.
Make a motion to approve Ordinance 847, extending the terms of a franchise for the supply and distribution of natural gas branded Black Hills Gas Distribution LLC, DBA Black Hills Energy, FKA Source Gas Distribution LLC on first reading.
Second.
All right. Motion by Kathy, second by Bobby. Receive a vote, please.
Debbie?
Yes.
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
That motion passes with all saying yes. Next is Resolution 1834, approving a contract with Loris Trucking LLC for the installation of sidewalk chases at Sharp Farms in the amount of $10,290. That was a consent agenda item that was removed back for discussion, and we're going to defer to AJ somewhat. We may not be prepared, council, mainly because Public Works is not here, and they are the spearhead of most of these projects. As they submit them to the administration reviews them and then submits them to council for approval. So if there's no questions to be able that are answered, it's nothing that the administration has done, it's just that we were not prepared for that because it is a consent agenda. If you guys do have questions about the consent agenda, the way it's supposed to work is you're supposed to reach out to the mayor and not the administrator. You can reach out to me. AJ is very transparent. He's here. He's available. If you have questions, do not have, you always hear him say, my phone's on. The guy could be in Tahiti and he says, my phone's on. The guys, believe me, I've texted him late at night yelling and screaming. He's like, hey, sorry.
I'm in Canada.
Don't encourage you to do that at night either.
Toronto lately.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So that being said, don't ever hesitate to call AJ if there is a question. You're not doing anything wrong. I know for a fact this council has the best interests of the citizens at heart. So if there's a question, just to save you guys the time, ask away. And he can always bring it up or put it in his report. Hey, a council member had a question. This is what it was. But just to save that way, you don't feel embarrassed about what you're doing. This is purely a process and it's governmental representation. So with that, AJ, you want to present first or you just want
to question?
Yeah, I can.
Okay.
I got a little bit of information.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I'm sorry that I didn't reach out to you yesterday and today just kind of got away from me. I just was concerned because I'm looking at the bids and I see one that's $10,290, which is the one that we're going for. Not that I don't want to pay less, but I'm wondering what's the difference between these bids? You know, that one is half the price of the others, you know. He's saying he had 735 feet, I believe, and the other two were saying like 21 chases, and I just want to know why there is such a big difference. I'm afraid that because I live in that subdivision,
yeah,
you know, that it's going to get maybe done on the cheap or the quality of work. I don't know.
Sure. So thanks to the modern miracle of these things we all carry. Even though John isn't here, I was able to give him a heads up and ask some information, and then that's why I ran out to take the call that he came in. So I was able to talk to John. It says Soto & Sons Truck. I think it's just a leftover because it's Loro's truck.
Yeah, that does.
But in the memo. But we have used the same company before for asphalt patching and concrete work, not on the big projects that we do with a big road replacement for. But they've done sidewalk replacement and asphalt patching when we've had to come in or there's been some settling or anything. John is pleased with the quality of his work, and one of the reasons he's got a lower price is because it's just a couple people outfit. It's not bigger companies like Asphalt Coatings and Front Range Concrete that are giant companies.
Right.
So he's been satisfied with the quality. While there's not a warranty term, John had mentioned there was, but I didn't see one in his proposal or in the agreement. But if the concern is quality of work, one of the things in the resolution, it authorizes the mayor to negotiate, you know, on behalf, as long as it doesn't substantively change the resolution or the proposal or the agreement, we can insert a warranty period in there if that would help ease the any of the concerns that council has.
Okay.
And you've got, I guess, for my own concrete chases.
Oh, it says.
Is that the?
The two of bids are going by Chase, where Laurel's is going by square footage, and
okay,
that could
make
you. A big difference.
Right.
It is.
Yeah, it does.
Okay.
It does.
So it's just, it's a blanketed word.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I
so,
get it.
So the Chase is, so the problem is the slime that overtops the sidewalk because
yes.
of the sump pump discharge.
Yes.
They run over the top of the sidewalk. I mean, we've since started modifying our standards and specs to be able to cut those back farther in new subdivisions. It's one of those lessons learned things.
Right.
So we have had some residents out there, Val being one of them, who had, on their own dime have done that replacement. But there are, you know, more areas than, you know, than there's just not, there's a few, more than a few. So for the price, it's just easier for the city to go in and do this and take care of those areas. But it's where the water in it, you know, will freeze in the winter and then the slime will,
yep.
come up in the summer. So this, what this does is puts a little drain underneath
yep.
the sidewalk. So it goes into the flow pan. So,
nice.
And as you know, in some of the areas we have issues with the flow pan.
Yes.
So that'll be another item for consideration down the road. We're getting the design for those two areas in Sharp Farms done now. It may not be able to be accomplished this year just due to the sheer cost, or maybe half this year, half next year. We're just waiting to see, but it will put it into the flow pan, which ultimately should go then into the next, the closest drain, storm drain.
And just for point of reference in my own mind, RFPs generally aren't awarded being the least expensive. Sometimes you guys have decided by quality more than, and if you have a relationship built with people, because I know I've seen some contracts come through where it's like, oh, you know, this one's $600 more. Oh, we've used them this many times, and this is for the amount of money that we're spending. We're going to get this benefit. Or we're going to benefit from this, and that's been throughout everywhere I've seen through the whole area. I've definitely, I'm not saying that we've spent the least amount or we've gone cheap, but I'm saying it sounds like John's had faith in this company. We've used it before because I know there's some other big projects with some big digs that we've had around there where we've used a guy out further east, and he's been like super good with us and has done a lot of projects. So just for reference, that's why we don't just pick the least expensive person.
Sure, I didn't
sometimes.
Think we were picking the least
yeah.
expensive person.
Okay.
I just was wondering, you know, what's the deal here? Because one, that guy was half the price
right.
or even a third of the price of the
right.
other bid.
Yeah.
So it concerned me.
Yeah, and no, and I'm just, based upon my own experience, I've seen that where I've got a few friends of mine that are landscapers that have gone into neighborhoods and know that the neighborhood is affluent and just jack the price up by 8 or 12 grand knowing that they'll pay it. And it's amazing just by that just basic water cooler talk from those people that they said, oh yeah, I'll go into this neighborhood here knowing that it's the homes are $1 million homes and I'll hit them for an exorbitant amount of money knowing that they'll pay it. So that, and I'm not trying to talk bad about the other contractors. I'm saying
sure.
that they probably have their own punch card lists and how they come up with their formula and how they do that. So just in, you know.
And that square footage versus per chase might make a big difference.
Yeah.
Because that's
you.
How
because
he
what they're doing
quoted
they
it by a number
per
of square feet.
Unit
so
instead
so
of just doing it per the lineal
yeah.
feet.
Right.
Yeah.
Because when you break it down per the lineal feet, then you've got all your cost of material and everything else built in.
Right.
So when you're bidding on all this stuff, that's how the landscapers and every other contractor ends up figuring out their estimates to do their total job. So then they don't go over that budget. Otherwise, you know, they lose money. Nobody can afford to do that. And when you're in this for a while, like John has, what ends up happening is you use a company more than once. So their reputation and their history and their trustworthiness to do it for the price they said, that has a big bearing on what it does, not just the cost. So it's like when you go out and you do request for proposals, it's just not saying, okay, who's gonna beat the price.
Well, sure.
So it's kind of an all intertwined process when it goes through this. So in that way, everybody makes sure that they're getting the best value for what we need done.
Yeah, and best practices.
So now we don't have to worry so much because we already have past experience with them. So
nice.
Well, that being said, there is one spot in that subdivision on Stonehaven Street Circle of the sidewalk there where the meter, you've seen it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure that's on the
list. And I think I have a picture that, who do I need to send it to? AJ? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. Cool. All right. No, any other discussion, Council?
So we can, when I get that location from Chris, we can see what they would charge while they're out there to take care of
it. While they're in there, yeah. I mean, it's
right. I know exactly what you're talking about.
You know
about.
What
yeah.
I'm talking about. It's like it's crumbling.
The whole sidewalk
is right there by
because
where
of that slime that's on top. I don't think the homeowner ever goes out and does anything to it ever. I would have to spray
well,
it off.
Well, it's cleaned
something.
Up. It's already.
Is it?
It's dry. It's not leaking like that anymore, but it got corroded and it's right down there
it's
where the gutter
apart.
Is. And it's breaking apart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So also, the other two proposals, one has, they both have a warranty component to them.
Right.
And if council wants to add that to the motion when they make, we can also make sure that's.
Is that like asphalt? Where asphalt gives you 10, 15, whatever their warranty is. You know, when they lay the asphalt, then they've come back in here and seal it, and you still have a warranty after that? Concrete
this
the same way?
Said, so one of them has a 2-year, and it just says 2-year, and then the other one has 1-year warranty on workmanship and materials. Warranty shall not apply to cracks, drainage with less than 2% slope, or... No, they do have some limitations, but once they apply that treatment to the
right.
to the asphalt, they typically don't need to come back unless there's spalling
right.
or something like that happens, and that it's obviously was a bad mm. mixture or the treatment got
right.
put on wrong or something. So we can add a term in there to give us all some better assurance.
Yeah, and that way at least we know. You know,
I'll forward it to you and then I'll go get the address for you because it.
Yeah.
We can just send the guy the bill, find out that address, and no, I'm just. We'll just since he's not washing it off, what's his name? No. Send the police over there right away.
It's not even where it is, it's right by the
manhole
thingy there.
Cool.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
Cool.
Walk through there.
All right. Any other questions for the administration? All right, Council, we'll look for a motion. We'll just put it back in your lap, Chris.
Okay. I'll make a motion then to approve.
All right, motion by Chris, second by Robin. Can we receive a vote, please?
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
That motion passed with all saying yes. That concludes the general business in the gigantic city of Dacono. And we will move to staff reports, and I believe we'll go down the line with AJ first.
Yes.
Let's do this.
I don't know if I hit everyone before. I want to make sure everybody has a copy of an updated proposal from the Carbon Valley Help Center. If not, I have an extra over here. And then this community training by the Carbon Valley Communities That Care
that's being done at the rec center at the end of the month. Just wanted to make you both aware of those. Fred Skates with the Health Center will be at a future meeting to go over this, and he understands we're not in budget season yet and isn't expecting an answer at any point, but just to maybe be considered during budget season. Our scholarship application deadline for students that reside in Dacono was this past Friday. We received 10 applications. Two of them, just by the initial criteria, won't be in the running, unfortunately. So we have $2,000 that was budgeted towards that. Last year, if you'll recall, we received 12 applications. Two were disqualified. And then council chose to award 10 of those who were qualified a $500 scholarship, which required a budget amendment, which we do about every year. We only try to do one of those a year towards the end of the year when we capture some of the things that come up from time to time like this. So I'll be happy to forward all those applications if a council member wants to, you know, be on a little group to go over those. Be happy to do anything council would like. GPA requirement is 2.5 or higher.
So this positive note, really quick, that's from state sponsored. Because doesn't COG train us and CML train us?
No, this is a different, it's a little...
Because they've got a state form down here. Does that mean they're just using that?
That's where they get some money from.
All right, so they're not official.
Shaley works for Weld County.
Yes.
That's where she kind of offices out of.
Okay.
This is specifically targeted for youth.
Right. Okay.
You know, gain insight to youth development, learn how to navigate difficult conversations with youth, how to create space to start the conversation, develop skills to help young people reach their full potential. It's targeted towards youth, and it's a 3-hour training with dinner at the Carbon Valley Recreation Center.
Okay, that's way above my pay grade. Next is, sorry. So last year we did this scholarship thing, and we kind of set precedence by doing that, which is cool if council's comfortable with that as far as the GPA being qualified, right? You'll obviously submit something to us if we want to do that, which I'm okay with. My one strange question, or I guess just comment, is I guess I'm uncomfortable with when dad says no, mom says yes, and it has nothing to do with the scholarships. I'll segue into the Carbon Valley Help Center. And for some reason, when we have either elected officials that were on some type of a board, not Dacono, and then they're able to know how city budgets work and are useful, and then they come and ask for money and we tell them no, and then they come back and they ask again. It's kind of strange because I think this council is very generous with the contributions, especially like a scholarship if you're trying to get an education out there. I'm not sure how many times we have to tell the Help Center no, so I'm sure that it might not be a pretty meeting if he comes again. Not to be mean to them, it's just like we seem to get these requests after budget. And we've already kind of gone through, I think all of us go through these budget meetings and we spend X amount of hours doing it. And by the time we're doing the contributions, we are generous. I think that was amazing with the scholarships last year. If council feels fit to do that again, that's something that you're building the future of your children. I'm not sure what the whole Help Center is. I haven't pushed that much to get involved with it. I know that I've been approached many times when I'm meeting, being asked for money from that thing. So I think I'm maybe ranting or squawking about it because I've got a salty taste in my mouth about that whole deal. So apologize to council for doing that. I just don't keep like getting asked the same question. And the money keeps getting larger and larger. And then first it was this amount of money. Now it's a large, to me, 5-figure amount. And it's a per annum. So every year to give them that. And then the person who's asking for the money knows how budgets work and said, well, you don't have the money over here because we've had it over there, and it's manipulating of where, kind of dictating how we can give them the money. And I just don't Just sorry for ranting. So, how much, just not comfortable with
how
the
much
whole thing.
Did we give the help center this year in the budget? Any idea?
AJ can get back to us on that. I'm not sure if we even. I wasn't a big fan of doing it, but I'm one vote.
If we know it for next time,
it may have been like 500 to 1,000.
Yeah. Now we're getting asked for 10 times that amount annually. So it's just like, okay, it seems like we keep going to the same trough, and it's like, well, you know, Dacono has a bright future, and our focus has not been on, our focus has been on education, bettering the city, quality of life, you know, health and human resource benefits to our citizens, live, play, eat in
Dacono. Did we also find out if other, it was mentioned that the other tri-town towns were giving 10,000?
No.
Did we find out if they did?
They were no's.
Okay.
I've reached out to one mayor and it was a no, and I didn't hear any back from the other mayor, but one of the mayors to the north of us said no, and the other mayor further north did not get back to me.
So on the scholarships, there's 8 qualified, and if we did 500 again, that's 4,000, correct? Yeah. So do we have money in the budget to double our budgeted allocation?
Overall, yes. In that line item, no.
Yeah,
exactly.
So
what we did
last year.
And as a side note, I would probably recommend moving forward, we just nudge that number
to 4,000.
And then if it's less than that,
yeah, we've had where it's been less and not ever gotten hurt.
I think the council all agrees on that.
Yeah, I mean, education is super important. Every one of us, we see these kids rolling in here anyway.
I would be happy to review them if you want to send them. Does anybody else want to review?
I could do that.
I'll put them all in Dropbox.
Okay.
And
cool.
Send the link, and that way you guys can just take a peek and, you know.
Thanks. I thought it was really great last year. You know,
yeah.
These kids came in.
They're, you know, when you award it and call them out, I think last year we handed them out to them and had them all up here, and they were,
yeah,
you know, that's fun. That's the fun part of the job, right? Instead of,
we
you know,
right. House too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And some of the majors, you know, the colleges are, you know, biochemistry, lodging management, nursing, mathematics, psychology, social work, studio arts, all range of colleges, Erie High School, Goal Academy, Centaurus High School, Frederick, Erie Prospect. So it's students that live in Dacono that just go to, you know, all different types of.
And the Well County Bright Futures changed their, it can't be go to any school. It has to be a school within a certain distance from Well County and or neighboring state. They just changed that.
Hmm.
It used to be go to New York, but now
right.
It's not.
Wow, yeah, because, yeah. Yeah, because I went to one ceremony where they were giving out scholarships, and
yeah.
One, two of the
they
people were going to West
this,
Point.
This year, right?
Military Academy,
yeah.
And gave
yeah.
Money.
But well, then
it
we have one
miles,
last year that went to West, or was going to West Point.
There was
that
a
girl.
Yeah,
was
yeah
a girl.
There was a girl. Yeah. And yeah, it was really
yeah.
Cool. They had a general or a full board colonel up. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Remember that? So that's
yeah,
super awesome.
I do.
Yeah, that's exciting.
Mm-hmm.
What else, AJ?
That's all I have, unless there are any questions.
Questions for AJ since we've. Any other staff reports, town clerk, city clerk, sorry, attorney, planning, police, fire, citizens, council?
Yeah.
Council this way?
I do have a question. You say police and fire, and when is fire's report? I forget when it is. Is it May? Is it coming up?
That's a great question.
Debbie, we need to talk.
What did I do?
So,
what did fire?
Nothing.
What did fire?
You're doing good, Debbie.
Okay.
You, go ahead.
So I had a meeting with Chief.
The new chief.
New chief.
Chief Beebe, who was made, he was interim, and now they made him the permanent chief. And I brought up that same question because we have it on the agenda for kind of general time every year.
Is it about me?
it was right about this time.
Oh, okay.
Yes,
win
the conversation.
The new chief has decided to take a new approach and just kind of come as needed. So there was a story in the paper about some new fire trucks they got. He mentioned, without me even asking, the ambulance that was in at the Dacono station, that it's there about 70% of the time, depending on staffing. And so the mayor had also, interestingly enough, maybe based on that story or something, asked me about it. And so I can reach out to the chief, and if there's any other questions, I can kind of give him a list and say, can we schedule a time that you can come to a council meeting and talk about those issues and answer some questions?
I would like to. When they came and presented last year, we told them to add to their annual report response times. So I would like to continue to receive response times, not only ambulance, but fire.
And I'm going to wholeheartedly 100% rely on Debbie based upon her experience with that section. I believe it was a couple of years ago that you brought up the same issue, the concerns, the timing. And at that time, they were talking about the calls were kind of a flip-flop, where most of the calls that bus is what they call an ambulance. The bus was heading over to Erie more so. And then I think Debbie and I had a conversation about it maybe even last year. And I had pushed Debbie and I said, I want you to be kind of the spearhead on that. So interesting enough, I didn't see the article. I was having breakfast at Gabe's. And two gigantic Rosenbauer fire trucks pulled up, and I saw one of the maintenance guys at the restaurant. And they were just delivering them, so I had a conversation with those guys, and they didn't have any information because they're just the nuts and bolts part of the guy. But I asked about the bus, so and then I asked AJ the same thing. I was asking to reach out to you soon and say, can we get rekindle that fire? I'd like to know why. If the bus is over here, the ambulance is over here 70% of the time. As you mentioned a couple years ago, then why can't it just stay here? And they have the means, because I believe they bought two new ambulances and then they refurbished three, took the boxes off, and then put them on the new frames. So they're ready and they're staffed, is what they're saying, and they have the funds, and they're definitely cash healthy.
The question is, when I have a heart attack, will they be there in less than 8 minutes?
Exactly. Yeah. So
that's the response time.
Yeah.
I had personal experience last year. They were at my home in less than 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Less than 10 minutes. So,
I would like it to be annual. I mean, if we're asking, let's tell them, put us on your calendar annually. We want that report. We need to see what they're doing and giving to our citizens for the amount of money we pay and they pay, because ultimately they're paying for the ambulance, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the old chief was here, used to be here maybe, you know, once a month, sometimes twice a month, and that's gotten away. I don't know what the politics are anymore because I'm not involved with that. I will be nice because my attorney's here. So I'll keep my mouth shut about that. Yeah. What else, Debbie?
That's it. I was just like, you know, where is fire? It's been a while, so it's due. Robin. So yes, if you could get him.
Anything?
No, it's a good question. Thanks, Debbie.
Mayor Pro Tem.
Yeah, so part of my duty as Pro Tem, I'll be going over the charter again this year. I expect to bring a menu of ideas to the council for modification, decision, whatever you decide to do as far as putting something on the ballot for November. So,
are you going to convene a group of us or just you reviewing?
I'm just going to do a first pass and then just provide that to all of you, and then whatever you decide I'm good with. I just want to get sort of a quick first blast across the charter. I'll be utilizing some of the stuff that's been done in years past as well. So,
is this a year we're going to put stuff on the ballot? Is it a good
year
for that?
Yeah, this is the year. So. Yeah, it's time.
We did that.
It'll be a high turnout year. And then we also talked about the High Plains Library District inclusion we'll start to gear up there.
It's time.
Yeah.
It's time.
Really fast.
Yes.
To try and get that on.
Yeah. So that's, and there's other things that I'm would obviously like to get. So mainly the charter review, get that done. Kevin's done a good job with that last time he did it, so.
Yeah, and if anybody has ideas or things that maybe I will overlook, please, by all means, send them my way.
Well, I think it's a good idea for you to kick it out first, and then we can all go over it, and then we can come back, you know?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. That's happening.
Right.
What else?
That's it.
So, you're stuck with AJ for at least another 5 years. Congratulations, and thank you for your service, AJ. I've always felt that he's been, love putting you on the spot, buddy. I've always felt that AJ's got the best interest of the city. As you know, I've definitely made some comments of, I've, you know, sure I've upset AJ or gotten mad at him getting mad at me. At the end of the day, I can wholeheartedly say no matter what's going on, how much I'm yelling or screaming, not literally, I know I can hang up the phone and know that the guy's got the heart of the city, the best intentions of the citizens in Dacono, 100%. There's never been a doubt in my mind. thank you for the reviews that you had given me about AJ. I appreciate that. I waited till everyone sent everything in, and then I did share them with AJ. I think that he can grow from those, and it's good to just know where that comes from. So thanks for that. I do appreciate it. I wasn't going to tell you that I shared him, but I wanted to do that because I have confidence in AJ, and he's definitely done a fantastic job. There's another section that I asked council to take care of, which was the challenges. I haven't really heard back from you, so some of the goals that I'm just going to put out there that I said were some short-term goals that you think this council can accomplish by the end of the year, and some long-term goals that this council can accomplish even if you're not on council. So some of the things I'd like to see as a council member, at least by the end of the year, is the finishing of the safety zones. You can see red blinking lights going on, and there's a limited sight distance on Weld County 8, and your speed, you're going too fast. And it's more just trying to just keep people under control. I think I was making comment to you about the speeds coming off 52. How do you control that? Mm-hmm. And we've witnessed, you know, I've been here and I know of at least, I think, three fatalities that have happened on 52 since I've been in the mayor's office. So those being said, I'd like to just get them finished. We are cutting a ribbon this year, ladies and gentlemen, to a brand new school, which is really, really cool. And then there's ballot issues that I'm going to push. One of them is council's pay and the commissioner's pay again. I'm pushing that mainly because I think that it's not a money issue. None of you are here and said, I want all this money. It is truly a sense of service, okay? I felt bad and I was a little cagey with this customer or a citizen who was up here, and I'm like, everyone up here has jobs. We have to pay our bills. So, but even the commissioners do not receive anything. So I'm going to push as much as we can to get as much positive information out there and get them back on the ballot, and try to ask everyone here to push for that too, just because I think that, you know, I just feel you're all being underpaid. There hasn't been a pay increase for council members or mayors since 1980. So you're, 38 years? There hasn't been anything for the commissioner. So more just trying to bring everyone up to speed. You're within the city's means and within the town area. You're not doing anything inappropriate. So that's my rant with that. I think that's it. Next time we see each other is April the 28th?
23rd.
I'm done. Anything else? We'll look for a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Oh, we got doubles in there. Motion by everybody, second by everybody. Can we receive a vote, please? Or all in favor, single by saying aye.
Aye.
Sorry. Woohoo!